Hi everyone, my name is Dario Pasquini, and today I'm going to present you our recent work on password guessing. Here, we show how representation learning, which is the base of deep learning, can be used to cast novel attacks on textual passwords. This work has been done in collaboration with Ankit Gawal, Giuseppe Ateniese, Massimo Bernaschi, and Mauro Conti. Our approaches rely on a class of deep learning techniques called deep generative models that includes models such as GANs and variational autoencoders. In a very broad sense, a deep generative model is nothing more than a deep neural network that is trained to map a space that is distributed according to a very simple distribution in another space that shows a much more complicated but interesting distribution. The input space, which we call latent space, follows an easy-to-sample distribution chosen as hyperparameter before the training. This is typically a multidimensional Gaussian distribution. The output space, or data space, instead, captures a more articulated distribution, such as the one of natural images, or in the case of our work, the distribution of passwords. Once we have trained a generative model on a data set of passwords, we can use it to perform password guessing attacks. To this end, we have just to sample latent points from the latent distribution, so the Gaussian distribution, and using them as input for the generator, obtaining suitable passwords as output. The generated passwords then can be used as guesses for a password guessing attack. In particular, we mainly consider the case of offline attacks. Now, the idea of using models such as GANs in password guessing attacks is not new, but there is a very compelling property of those models that has never been exploited for this task. This is about how the neural network organizes the latent space during the training. Indeed, in the general case, we have that two close points in the latent space are always mapped into similar points in the data space, where the term similar refers to a semantic similarity defined in the data space. In the slide, an example of how this mechanism works for face images. Here, faces with similar attributes lie close to each other in the latent space. Of course, the same property works also for passwords. In this case, generally speaking, we have that all the passwords with a similar structure tend to be clustered within specific zones of the latent space. This implies an explicit organization in the latent space that allows us to capture password similarity simply through the Euclidean distance among latent points. That is, we know that the latent points with a small distance map to passwords that are strongly correlated. For instance, passwords that have similar structure and share substrings. On the other end, when distance increases, the similarity between the passwords decreases. Hereafter, we refer to this general property of the latent space with the name of password locality. Being aware of the password locality property allows us to exploit in a different way the password generation process offered from a deep generative model. As we introduced before, we can generate passwords by simply sampling points from the latent distribution we defined before the training. However, this procedure does not give us any control on the kind of passwords we are going to generate. In a different way, exploiting the natural organization of the latent space, we can force the generator to produce specific classes of passwords by just focusing our exploration of the latent space in specific zones. The most natural way to achieve this is to manipulate the distribution from which we sample latent points during the generation process. For instance, we can just move the mean and reducing the scale of such a distribution, so we can focalize to generate a specific class of passwords. In this direction, the only problem is to define which class of passwords we want to generate and find the zone of the latent space where this class is located. To this end, we must rely on an additional component. This is an encoder network that is trained to map the data space into the latent space rather than the latent space into the data space as the generator. Using this encoder, we can just choose a guide password and use it to localize a specific zone of the latent space from which we sampled similar passwords. To this end, we simply map the guide password into the latent space via the encoder, obtaining a latent point Z. Then, we use Z as mean for a Gaussian distribution with a certain scale sigma, which is a hyperparameter. Finally, we sample latent points according to the latent distribution and map them into the data space, so producing passwords that are similar to our guide password. Additionally, we show that in this approach, the chosen guide password can be expressed under the form of a template rather than a string. That is, we can specify the guide password with missing characters using special wildcard symbols. When sampling from the latent space, the model will automatically find the best fit for these missing characters, producing suitable guesses. This approach allows us to express a more general guidance during the generation process and allows us to deal with incomplete information that can be useful in certain applications. Indeed, this kind of password generation process can be useful in different scenarios. The most natural application for an attacker is to rely on this approach to generate passwords with certain structure, given some known properties of the target set. This approach can be also used to recover full passwords from side channel attacks that have been able to recover only partial strings. Another example is the one of a user who tries to recover a lost password, relying on a partial memory of it. More importantly, this approach represents the foundations of our core contribution, a technique that we call dynamic password guessing. Very briefly, this technique is about adapting the guessing strategy on the fly, basing on the interaction with the attacker set of passwords. The aim of dynamic attack is to exploit a very common property of real-world password distributions that is often forgotten during simulated password guessing attacks. This property is induced from the fact that every password distribution generated from a specific environment shows peculiar biases. These biases are naturally induced from the combination of different factors, such as the user's language, the password composition policy, and the community interest. More importantly, these biases make the passwords created by different users within the same environment not independent from each other. This mainly translates in the fact that knowing a subset of a password set tells us about the remaining passwords in the set. So, relying on this simple intuition, an attacker can drastically improve the attack performance by just accounting for the passwords guessed during the running attack. Here comes our dynamic attack. The core idea behind this approach is that if the password X is in the set, there is a quite high probability that also passwords similar to X have been chosen by different users within the same environment. So, observing X, we should change our expectation on the other unknown passwords containing in the set we are attacking. Very pragmatically, changing our expectation means changing the guesses we want to perform next according to the new guessed passwords. Now, the only problem remains to find a way to implement such reasoning in practice, and more importantly, find a way to combine and generalize the information received from the multiple passwords guessed during the attack. Well, the latent space offers us a very elegant way to implement this procedure. In the paper, we propose a very simple algorithm that exploits the password locality property to implement dynamic password guessing we described before. During the attack, we start by sampling from the original latent distribution and testing the produced guesses against the attacked set of passwords. Now, if we have a match, what we do is centering the latent distribution in the latent point of the password we just guessed. In doing so, we increase the probability of the password similar to the matched one of being generated next time we sample from the latent distribution. Now we are ready to generate a new password We sample a new point from the updated latent distribution and produce a new guess. We test the guess on the target set, and if it is a match, we repeat the procedure. We create a new Gaussian centered in the new latent point, and we insert it into the latent distribution. In particular, what we do is creating a mixture of Gaussians, where each kernel is induced by a password guess during the attack. Within this approach, match after match, we add new kernels in the mixture. In doing so, we are able to better adapt to the unknown distribution of the attack set and automatically capture its biases. In practice, the attack looks something like this. On the right, we have the whole hotmail.com leak mapped into the latent space via the encoder network. Whereas on the left, the animation describes how our guessing strategy evolves during the attack. In particular, each red point is a guessed password, while the blue halo captures the density of the latent distribution. As you can see from the blue halo, the attack automatically focuses on the densest zone of the target space without any form of supervision. The dynamic attack can be very effective. The plot reports the performance comparison on a set of passwords for a GAN-based model. The red line is the performance of the static GAN model, while the green line is the same model but with the dynamic adaptation of the latent distribution we introduced before. The gain obtained with dynamic attack is particularly large when we attack a password set that follows a distribution that is different from the one we use to train the model. In these cases, the attack can also outperform state-of-the-art approaches, such as the ones based on recurrent neural networks. More interesting are the kind of passwords that dynamic attacks are able to guess. Indeed, the adaptation procedure seems to allow us to guess very peculiar passwords of the attack distribution. These are passwords that have very low probability according to the training set of the model, but that are present in the target set we are attacking. The table reports some examples of this kind of passwords for the Yahoo leak. As can be observed, with the dynamic attack, we are able to guess passwords that would require up to 6 orders of magnitude more guesses with state-of-the-art approach. In conclusion, we propose one of the first dynamic password models by relying on the latent space of a deep generative model. We show how this attack is capable of guessing peculiar passwords of the attack distributions thanks to the information automatically recovered during the attack. This approach is extremely general and resorts to deep learning techniques that are in continuous evolution and improvement. However, this has also some drawbacks. Mainly, such a technique can be quite slow, and it is sensitive to hyperparameter choice. For this reason, in a follow-up work, we distilled what we have learned with this approach in a much more efficient formulation based on dictionary attacks. Thank you for your attention. Please refer to our paper for additional results.